Hello students, I am back again to discuss the topic bioassay of an insecticide in laboratory. So you all are welcome, and let's first discuss what is a bioassay. So bioassay is a procedure or a test for estimating the concentration or potency of a toxicant or an insecticide or rodenticide by measuring its effect on a living system compared to a standard system. It is performed to determine the strength of the chemical from the degree of response elicited by the animals, and not to estimate the toxicity or the concentration of the chemical which is toxic to the organisms. Bioassays are frequently used in drug and pharmaceutical industry to evaluate the potency, the strength of the drugs, chemicals, vitamins, etc. Now, what is bioassay answering to? Bioassay answers the questions like whether a compound or an insecticide or a toxicant is toxic, or if it is toxic, then to how much extent. Then, does the toxicant vary in its toxicity? Is the toxicant biodegradable, or if it is not biodegradable, then how much it is toxic? Now, bioassay is done by conducting acute and short-term test. You all know what is acute test and what is a chronic test. The understanding of median lethal dose or lethal concentration and toxicity is very important to evaluate the bioassay or to evaluate the toxicity of a compound. In aquatic mediums, we know we use lethal concentration, 50% of 50 lethal concentration, which is also known as LC50. Now, response of a chemical or a toxicant is of two types. It is either quantile response or it is a graded response. When we discuss quantile response, we mean to say that it is either all or it is a none response. Means either a thing happens or a response is elicited by an animal or it is not elicited at all. Toxicologists generally prefer quantile response, in which LC50 or LD50 are used. These values are determined for a toxicant. Then the graded response is one in which the toxicity is determined, but the response is either it is graded, means it may range from 0 to 100. It may be 10%, 20%, 30%, and so on till 100%. Means it may grade, it may show a gradation. Now, what is the methodology of a bioassay in the laboratory? What we do is, first we take, if we are conducting a bioassay on an insecticide, then we need to have batches of insects, and these batches are usually of about 10 to 20 insects. The batches are these type of batches are known as small batches, in which 10 to 20 individuals are included in one batch. These batches are made from the random population, means they do not depend on the age, sex, or different nutritional status of the insects. So we collect random samples from the population and make their batches. Then the toxicity is usually determined by using a dose response relationship. The test animals should be divided at random into several groups. Usually there are six groups are formed for conducting a bioassay. The first group is used for the control experiment or the standard experiment, in which standard conditions are made available to the group of insects, and they are given only the solvent. They are not given the toxicant or the insecticide. Then the other five groups, in which the toxicant is dissolved in the solvent, means the test groups are given dosages in geometric progression. These geometric progression means they may be like 1, 3, 9 and 27, or 1, 2, 4 and 16, this way. So after the insects are exposed to different concentrations of an insecticide, they may or may not be kept in another container, and they may be provided food later on, or may not be provided the food. That depends on the method we are employing to determine the bioassay. Then after a few days time, which is pre-decided. The mortality count is taken, and often a few insects are seen to die during the experiment due to natural causes. These natural causes are not concerned with the use of insecticide. The magnitude of the mortality should also be estimated. This can be done by exposing to the batch of insects in the control experiment to exactly the same environmental conditions of exposure which are given to the test animals. Next is, this bioassay design is based on 3 to 7 dosages. You don't calculate a bioassay by simply giving only one dose to the test animals. You have to take at least 3 to 5 doses, and then you have to check which dose is the most suitable. These dosages are chosen on the basis of previous studies or the pilot studies performed, so that the LD50 should be as near to the center of the dosage level as it is possible. The dosage mortality curve can be approximated by a straight line, at least in the neighborhood of the, means it should be nearest to the LD50 when the mortality at given doses is plotted by the plotted against the logarithm of the dose. For this reason, these doses are chosen in geometric progression so that the logarithm of the doses increases by equal increments. When there is natural mortality among the controls, the mortalities have to be corrected by Abbott's formula, which I'll leave in the notes. The understanding of the median lethal dose, median lethal concentration and toxicity is very important for the better evaluation of the toxicity of particular pesticides. To sum up, we have discussed about the LD50, LC50 in earlier videos, which you can refer again if you want to recollect. So hope you have a basic idea of a bioassay and how it is conducted in the laboratory. If you are able to follow it, please let me know. And yes, feel free to ask any questions if you have any, and leave them in the comment box. I'll answer them. And for now, let's say goodbye.